here. When I enter, you reduce. Okay? I pray that God will do His work in our life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If you don't reduce, when you don't stop, God is disconnected. Okay? Raise up your sword, O Lord. Jehovah, raise up your sword, O Lord, for battle. Raise up your sword.
Amen.
Every wicked power that has arrived. the Spirit.
Every wicked power that has changed you. Listen to me. As I'm speaking right now, there are people in a prison cell. You must be released from this prison cell. Whether you know it or not, you must be released. You must come out from that place. There's what is called a prison cell of the soul, a prison cell of the Spirit, a prison cell of the body. If you are in this prison cell, there is no way you can effectively serve the Lord. You will see that you are changed. You will see that you are changed. That's why you see yourself in your dreams. You cannot remember your dream. It's a prison yard of the soul. It's a prison cell of the soul. You are coming out today. I say you are coming out today. I say you are coming out today. You saw yourself in the dream all of a sudden. You saw yourself just back there when you used to be with some friends, like walking friends. Listen to me very well. The spirit of delay must be broken. Today, the spirit of delay will be broken. I said the spirit of delay will be broken. I said it will be broken in the name of Jesus. Listen to me. Why I so much believe in deliverance is that without deliverance, there are powers that will not allow you to live a holy life. They will be holding you. Even if you want to live a holy life, there are some people right now, you know, you see yourself, you don't pray. When I mean you don't pray, there's no joy to pray. There's no peace and happiness to pray. You don't just want to pray. That's a sister that is hearing. You don't just want to pray. You see yourself, you are just very cold. Even though you raise up and say, let me pray for 10 minutes, it won't work. You know why? When you are in a prison cell, mostly the prison cell of the spirit, they will ensure that you don't pray. You know why? Because if you pray, a lot of things will be opening. That's why tonight, a lot of doors will open. Amen. A lot of doors. A lot of doors. Whether the devil likes it or not, whether it is convenient for the devil, not till I tell the devil, my life is open. If there's any hidden sin or secret sin you see in my life, you can hold it back. You can hold it back. I am sure nothing will take it. But if there's no secret sin in my life is open. And there's nothing you can use to hold me back in the second heaven. There must be miracles in the life of the children of God. You have been walking, but you are not walking. You have been walking, but you are not walking. This one is a prison yard. You have been walking, but you are not walking. It's not as if the money will not enter your hand, but you are not walking. In the spiritual realm, you are not walking. In the physical, you are walking. When I mean walking, that you are walking in a particular place. In the spiritual realm, you are not walking. In the physical, you are walking. It's a chain. It's a chain that must be broken. I say it's a chain that must be broken. Whether the devil likes it or not, you will tell the devil. You will tell that devil whatsoever he has said in your life. I say to be released by fire in the name of Jesus. Amen. Sometimes last year, my mom had a terrible sickness, which was supposed to take her life. I and Brother Godwin, we went to the hospital, we prayed. I realized that my mom's calf was in a kingdom. I saw her scarf. This guy said, this is my mom's scarf. This is her dress. This is her